gentlemen, continuing on with the fights, this eighth bout will be 3 2-minute rounds in the welterweight division. Set to make his way to the cage, out of the blue corner, Victor Verdugo.
Victor Drago Verdugo, 0-0, making his debut, age 28. Weighed in at 176 pounds, 6'2", fighting out of Intensity MMA. And the Intensity guys have really shown up today, and I think we got another one on our hands.
Yeah, his older brother is in the title fight tonight.
Right, right. And I mean, especially when you have siblings that are fighters, that is that type of sibling rivalry. I mean, you know, Rotulio brothers, is that how you say their last name? Yeah, right? Exceptional competitors in their own right, but a good portion of that might be because they have a sibling they're trying
to
beat. Their competition is at home. So,
you're fighting at the gym, you're fighting in the cage, fighting at home. You're getting training in all the time.
I mean, do y'all even fight at home or just keep the bees? Because you be fighting in the gym all the time.
Hey, for some of the brothers I've trained, they fought all the time.
So I've heard.
And his opponent making his way to the cage out of the red corner, Danil Leontev.
And Danil Leontev, age 19, weighed in at 177.9 pounds, 5'10", fighting out of Superior MMA. And another debuter, and these debut fights are such a dice throw.
Yeah, because you never know what you're going to get. You can get somebody who looks like an actual debuter amateur. Then you get the guy like we just had in the last fight, looking like he's a seasoned pro, throwing spinning wheel kicks and shit.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and some guys are killers in the gym, can't show up on fight night.
Exactly.
And vice versa. I know plenty of guys that are, you know, above average in the gym, but then you put them in competition and they're just murking people.
Talk about practice?
Talk about practice? I show up to play.
I show up to the game, not practice.
And you got the training center over in his corner as well. I mean, the coaching staff plus the high-level pros they got there, I guarantee you they are ready to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout will be 3 2-minute rounds in the welterweight division. Introducing first, out of the Boardwalk Recovery blue corner, he is making his MMA debut, standing 6'2" tall, weighing in at 176 pounds even, representing Intensity MMA. He hails from San Diego, California, presenting Victor Drago Verdugo. And his opponent across the cage, out of the Wolf of West Coast red corner, he is also making his MMA debut, standing 5'10" tall, weighing in at 177.9 pounds. He is also representing San Diego. Here is Danil Leontev. Referee in charge of the action, George Gallegos.
Referee getting both fighters against the fence. Getting him locked in. Daniel looks like You about to walk over him before the fight even starts.
He don't even want to step back. He's like, no, I'm ready to go.
I go forward.
I'm ready to smash, brother. He comes right out, pushing the guy back to the cage.
Trying to walk him down. He going, ooh, the standing.
That's a,
ooh.
He has the mounted Ezekiel, the Ezekiel choke.
And you can,
he has a locked-in Ezekiel choke from the bottom. Verdugo needs to put that head pressure down and try to get his head free, but I don't. Early dry, and the dude is strong right now. So he's squeezing. Victor is out, though.
And now he's straight on the back.
Nice.
With both hooks in. That was a really interesting choice to start off a fight.
Nice knees from Verdugo right up the gut. That's four unanswered.
And Daniel just throwing. Oh, that head kick just missed. They both are just ripping right hands right now. Oh, and they're just throwing again.
Hard.
You can see Daniel is just trying to land a big looping right hand.
But Victor Verdugo is game right now.
Yep. 30 seconds left in this round. He's holding on to the cage.
Where they're going, this does not look like an 0-0 fight.
You got to pause the timer when he was holding onto the fence to keep his opponent there.
Ooh, oh, nice. Leg
nice little
kick.
Low kick there. Oh, and Daniel lands at the perfect time. At the perfect time. He lands that big right hand, right?
Yeah.
And that's exactly how you want to end the round.
Yeah, with an exclamation point.
Especially, what an interesting choice. Early on, it must have been something that he was landing in practice. I mean, he went for that Ezekiel choke and was hanging on to it, even in mount. And then you can see Daniel also trying to crowd the tie clinch, block with his elbow so he can counter with the right hand over the top. There it was.
Yeah, Victor Verdugo, he's throwing those kicks almost standing straight up with his chin in the air,
yep.
As you see right there. That's why he got connected. He's throwing good kicks, but bad form.
Right, right. And here's where adjustments happen. Like, okay, this is where a coachable fighter is super helpful.
Exactly.
I mean, it's hard, right? You got to execute.
Well, this is where the coach comes into play.
Right, right.
Because on the outside of the cage, it's hard for you to differentiate him yelling or the rest of the crowd yelling, but when he gets to the corner, he's talking to you personally. He can give you all the instructions he's seen, and now you can make those adjustments, and you should be able to come through, and now it's up to you to listen to those adjustments and make it a different fight.
I mean, that one was close.
Very close.
Very, very close. I want to see who makes a change. Ooh, right hand just missed. For Victor.
Victor's coming in throwing good shots, but he's not putting anything together. They're all like single shots, nothing set up.
Ooh.
See, he's off balance.
Just chopping at the legs, though. I like that. Yeah, you got to put punches in front of that.
Ooh! Oh! Oh! Head kick! Knock out! Oh, my goodness! Daniel doesn't even know where he is. I think he got up and told George Gallegos he needs a can of corn.
Dang.
Call him mama.
He was just chopping at those legs. Just chopping at those legs. And then just goes high.
Smart man. You bring his legs, hands down, kicking him in the legs. Now you take it up top.
He just heavy low kicks.
The leg kicks. Opened him up, bam. And then right
and
to the top.
Just.
Right as he was stepping in, perfect on the chin.
That's one of my favorite ways to finish a fight. Prokop just.
What leg was that? Is he going to the hospital or to the cemetery? He going to sleep no matter what.
That was nasty. That was nasty.
Yeah,
and good job on the referee hopping in there. These are amateur fights. You know.
There's no need for him to take those extra punches on the ground.
Right. Eat those bombs. You know, that was an impressive head kick.
Beautiful. Luckily, he had on shin guards.
Right, absolutely.
Imagine the crack that would have been without shin guards.
Right.
He might have got blood on my suit. Somebody got blood on my suit!
Somebody actually did get
blood
on his suit.
Somebody actually did get blood on my suit. Damn. Back to the cleaners.
Somebody owes.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee George Gallegos calls a stop to the contest at 26 seconds of the second round for your winner by knockout, Victor Drago Verdugo.